Hello students, welcome to Microcontroller Lab. Myself, Rajkiran Gupta, Lab Assistant in Department of ECE, Rajiv Gandhi University of Knowledge Technologies, Basar. Today, we are going to discuss the first experiment, that is familiarization with Triton 2 kit's hardware and usage of Triton IDE along with Flash Magic for dumping the code to the controller by blinking onboard LEDs. The Triton 2 board is an embedded training and development platform. It has features that enable code development and exploration of embedded 8051 processor. The Triton board can be used to evaluate the 8051 processor with the associated peripherals. Now let's take a look at the layout of our Triton 2 board. The heart of Triton 2 board is IC89V51RD2, which is 80C51 microcontroller family IC with 40 pins, and features of 89V51RD2 are: it's a 64 KB on-chip flash user code memory with ISP and 1024 bytes of data RAM, and another feature is 5 volt operating voltage, 4 8-bit I/O ports, 16-bit timer or counter, 8 interrupt, and sources with 4 priority levels. Now let's see the peripherals of the Triton 2 board. This is serial interface. The Triton 8051 board has a single console serial port with a DB09 line interface. This port can be connected to a host system using a null modem cable through the DB9 connector, which is referred to as COM1 on the board. The serial ports are based on MAX232. The UART can be programmed to operate at speeds ranging from 300 to 115,200 bits per second mode. The second interface is LED interface. There are 8 LEDs which are connected to port 1 of the microcontroller, and the coming interface is keypad interface. The user 4x4 push button keypad rows and columns are connected to port 0 of microcontroller. Rows are connected to lower order 4 bits while the columns are connected to higher order 4 bits of the port 0 of the microcontroller. Next interface is 7 segment display. There are 2 7 segment displays, that are display 1 and display 2, which can be individually enabled using display 1 enable, which is connected to port 3.5, and display 2 enable, which can be enabled using port 3.4, and the data will be sent by port 2 of the microcontroller. And another interface is LCD display. There is a 16x2 LCD display on board whose data bus is connected to port 2, and register select is connected to port 3.7, and enable pin of this LCD is connected to port 3.6. Using them, we can send the data. Next interface is SDR memory card interface, MMC interface. We can save data to SDR memory card using this interface. Port 1's higher order 4 bits are used for data transfer to this interface. H1 box header used for external peripherals, which is connected to port 0. In the similar manner, we also have another 3 box headers, which are H2, H3 and H4, which are connected to port 1, port 2 and port 3 simultaneously to our microcontroller. And apart from these 4, we also have 20 pin box headers, which is H5 and H6. H5 is internally connected to port 0 and port 1 of the microcontroller, while H6 is connected to port 2 and port 3 of the microcontroller. Apart from this, there are various jumpers on board. User can configure the board according to the requirements. These are jumper for J4 and J5. Jumper will be selected. These jumpers will select USB to serial or UART. When one pin 1 and 2 are closed, then USB to serial is selected, and 2 to 3 are closed, then UART is selected. Next, jumper 3 will select backlight of LCD. When 1 and 2 are closed, then backlight is off, and 2 and 3 are closed, then backlight is on. S1, this switch is used for power on or off of the board. S2 will select LCD or 7 segment display mode of the board. Reset switch will reset the device into ISP mode. This is about the board description. We shall go for the blinking of LEDs. So this is the interfacing of LED with 89V51RD2 microcontroller, and you can see the port 1 of 89V51RD2 is connected to the onboard LED bank, which are in turn connected to the current limiting resistors, and as the port value gets high, that particular LED turns on. As the port value gets low, that particular LED turns off. Today we are going to interface our LEDs with our microcontroller 89V51RD2, and this is the board which we are going to use for our experiment, and this is Oasis board, and here you can see this 89V51RD2 microcontroller, and here there are 4 peripherals. Here one is keyboard, LEDs, LCD and 7 segment display on board. Apart from them, we also have some add-on boards which we will be dealing them later. So I mean, to implement a program or to make this board working, we need to have some software to be written, and to write that software we need to access Triton IDE. And to activate the Triton IDE, we also have some licensed dongles, which are called as USB dongles. This is the type of one we will be providing you when you are coming to our lab. And without this, our software will not work. Okay? So you need to simply insert it into one of your USB port, and it will get detected. And then we will be going for Triton IDE, which is available on your desktop. Simply click on it and it will get popped up, and let me close this previous program project. Here this is your Triton IDE. So as already our sir has said, that is Triton IDE means Integrated Development Environment. So here we are going to create a new project from this project menu, new C project, and here you need to simply give the project name as this is our first program, so simply type it as first, and then target is 8051, variant is 89V51RD2, operating system is none, port simply select it automatically sets to COM1, and baud rate is 9600, and our project, this is location of our file, will be browse to the location which we have set here, video lab, and then OK, and then video lab we are creating a new folder. Okay. So click next and then finish. It will create your first project here, and then simply click this, remove this, delete this. We are going to start from scratch. So simply right click on this first. This is our project now.
we are going to create a new source file. So hit for new and then source file, C source file. So I am giving first as our program. So first.c is our main program, and then finish, it will open up this window. And I have already copied some code here. Let us make our, this is the code which we have earlier written, and then save it by simply pressing Ctrl S, and build the program simply pressing Ctrl B. It will create an IHX file here. Okay, this IHX file, we are using it for dumping purpose. So this part is for development of our IHX board, and then we will be going for Flash Magic, which is already available on the taskbar. Simply click on the Flash Magic. And this Flash Magic, we need to give the source file. So here there are four steps here. Step one, select the variant or your microcontroller, whatever it is, 89E51RD2, and COM port, which we are using is serial port, so COM1, baud rate is 9600, interface non-ISP, and step 2 is arrays, arrays blocks used by firmware, and step 3 is our file location. We need to provide it, and here we cannot see that thing, so all files you select it, and then first.ihx select it, and then we no need to check all these things. Simply go for step 5, simply select start, and it will ask for reset the device into ISP mode. Simply reset it and it will get programmed here. Once the program is done, you can see that our kit is given, kit is being turned on. Simply press the reset button, as our sir has already said. You press simply reset, it will be making that these LEDs to turn off, as we have given only 0x00 as our input to our port 1, our output from our microcontroller to port 1 to our LEDs. So we need to change that thing to blinking mode. So simply edit this thing, uncomment this thing, and save it Ctrl S, and build it Ctrl B, and then in the Flash Magic simply hit this start button, because we have already selected this file. We simply go for start button, and it will ask for reset the device. Simply reset it, the programming is done, and then you can see here, once I press this reset button, our LED will be blinking there now. Okay, so this is our first program.